Sir, சொல்லிருங்க.
So good afternoon, participant. Let me start the afternoon session, followed by the morning session where I left. So in the morning session, we have discussed about the components of fuzzy expert system. Do you please remember there are four major components: fuzzifier, inference engine, defuzzifier, and fuzzy knowledge base. Out of the four component, the second component, inference engine, there are some models readymadely available. You just have to plug and play. Likewise, defuzzifier model also readymadely available. You have to plug and play. Where our task is there is, it is the duty of everyone when you are going to design an expert system to generate database as well as rule base for the data that you have in your hand. If you look at the diagram, see the fuzzy knowledge base, that is database and rule base, is used in all the modules. Fuzzifier module, that is fuzzifier component, inference engine component, as well as the defuzzifier component. In all the component, this fuzzy knowledge base is used. So the most important duty of any person who is interested to design a fuzzy expert system is to generate the fuzzy knowledge base first. That fuzzy knowledge base consists of two components. One is database, another one is rule base. So that I explained in the morning session. So among the four components, the most important component is fuzzy knowledge base, followed by fuzzifier component. Other two components are readymadely available that you can use it. The work that you need to perform while developing a fuzzy expert system is these two components. Let me explain how to develop this fuzzy expert system with the help of a tipping case study, that is a tipping problem. Let me explain the problem statement first. First, let me read the problem statement. Given the quality of service and the quality of food at a restaurant, what is the right amount to tip your wait person? So I think you understand from the problem statement, that is, imagine there is a person who is running a hotel and he has many employees. Those employees are, some employees are employed in the kitchen section. Some employees are employed in the section which is serving the food. So those are called wait person. Now, if I want to give salary to the wait person, then I need to deduce the tip amount received by the wait person. If that such kind of hotel manager is there in a hotel, then he need to ask each and every person, what is the amount that you got from the customer as a tip. Every time a hotel manager cannot go and ask the person, what is the amount you got. If the wait person says the exact amount, then automatically what happened? The hotel manager will deduce that tips amount and then will pay the rest of the amount as the salary. So normally what it happens, the wait person won't reveal the amount. Maybe he may say that, no, I didn't get any tips. Just it is the empty cover or empty empty cash voucher. It is like that, he can say. So in order to estimate how much amount a wait person can get from a customer, as well as in order to decide how much salary I can give for the wait person, so I need an expert system for which the input are quality of service and quality of food. So there are two input parameters. One is quality of service, how much quality the service is extended by the wait person to the customer, and how much quality the food is served by the wait person. So we are not talking about the person who is cooking the food. Here we are talking about only the person who is serving the food. So the quality of the food also, here it depends on the, as per the customer is concerned, here it depends on the wait person. So with this two parameter, that is input parameter, what we have to decide is how much amount a person can got from the customer. So remember, our objective is to find out the tips amount. From the tips amount, the hotel manager will deduce the tips amount and gives the remaining amount as the salary. So for which, first the hotel manager will have to estimate the tips amount. If he go and ask the wait person, he need not get correct information. So what he can decide is, he can design a kiosk at the exit of the hotel. Once the customer leaves the hotel, he can give a questionnaire with these two parameters. Rate the quality of service in our hotel in the range 0 to 10. Point number one. Point number two, rate the quality of food in our hotel in the range 0 to 10. If a customer gives some number between 0 to 10, then that value is accepted as input. And based on that input, the expert system will do some kind of task as explained in the design of fuzzy expert system, that is specification, inference, de-specification, generation of knowledge base. Everything is being done by the expert system. And finally, it gives out the amount, the tips amount. So what is it defined as a tips amount? Say, for example, if third input got from the customer is, what is the total bill? Say, for example, if the customer enters the total bill is 100, then the tips amount estimated by the expert system is 5% to 20% of the total bill. That is, if he pays 100 rupees for his food, then 5 rupees is the tips amount. It is estimated like that, which is the minimum amount. Otherwise, 25%, that is 25 rupees. That is, it is varied from 5% to 25% of the tips amount that covers the total bill of the customer. Participant, I hope you understand the problem. So imagine a kiosk that is placed at the end of the exit of the hotel. There you are going to collect three values from the customer after taking the food before leaving the hotel. One is quality of service in the range 0 to 10. Another one is quality of food in the range 0 to 10. And the total billed amount. By accepting the total billed amount, the system that is embedded into the kiosk will calculate the tips amount for the wait person. Then, based on the tips amount, the hotel manager will decide the salary for the wait person. So this is the scenario and this is the case study. For this case study, let me going to discuss how the fuzzy expert system is designed. What is the first task? Generation of database. What is the second task? Generation of rule base. So as far as generation of database is concerned, it is nothing but collection of membership function, as I explained in the morning session. So to generate as many as possible membership function, what you should do? First, you should divide the variables into as many as possible linguistics. Let me take the first parameter, quality of service. The quality of service parameter is divided into three linguistics: poor, good, and excellent. Likewise, the quality of food is divided into two linguistics: rancid and delicious. The output variable tips is divided into three linguistics: cheap, average, and generous. Once this task is said to be done, that is partitioning of input variable and output variable into linguistic variable. What are all the linguistic variable here? Poor, good, excellent, rancid, delicious, cheap, average, generous. They are all going to be linguistic variable. See, remember the meaning of the word lingual. Lingual is something in the way of speech. So what are the exact input variable? Quality of service, quality of food, and tips amount. After dividing the given variable into specified variable, then you have to associate a membership function for each variable. For poor, it may be of trapezoidal, triangular, Gaussian, bell. That is some commonly used membership function I discussed in the morning presentation. So those any one of those membership function can associated with the linguistic variable. For poor, one linguistic variable. So for poor, one membership function. Good, one membership function. Excellent, one membership function. Likewise, rancid, delicious, cheap, average, generous. For every kind, you have to assign the membership function. So after this process is said to done, then the task of generating the database is completed. After that, you need to go for generating the rule base. In general, the rule base is generated based on the opinions collected from the set of 8 persons. That is, you have to go to several hotels, ask the 8 persons, do you get tips? In what level you have get tips? Like that, you have to prepare a questionnaire, collect data, and according to the data that is collected by you, then you have to come to an idea for generating the rule base. So accordingly, the rule base generated for this problem is, if service is poor or the food is rancid, then tip is cheap. It is meaningful, right? When you are going to go to hotel, if you order for an item, the item is coming to you for a very long time, means you get irritated. Otherwise, if you ask any water or any other things, like if you order any things like curry or any other things, if the service is delayed or it is poor, then you will get irritated. Otherwise, if the food is not so good, what you expected, then automatically what you did, you won't pay a tip, or you may pay very less amount of tip, provided if the wait person expects you. So the rule is meaningful, right? Likewise, if service is good, tip is average. Remember the third rule, if service is excellent. So before you ask anything, the wait person is sitting in front of your desk and always asking, what do you need? What do you need? What do you need? If he is giving extra care to your desk and with a smiling face, then you may say that the service is excellent. And fortunately, the food taken by you in that hotel is very tastier as expected by you. That means it is very delicious. Then what you will do? You will pay more generous tips, provided if you are generous. So this might be some kind of conditional statements for the export system to work. So remember how to generate this rule base. It can be generated by some questionnaire preparation, or you have to go and ask as many as possible wait person according to the experience of the wait person, and according to your personal experience, or according to your neighbors or other friends or colleagues' experience, you can arrive such kind of rule base. There are other possible ways are also possible. Another possible ways is from the data. You can go and collect the data from the hotel. Accordingly, you can prepare generate the rule base. Otherwise, what you can do is, you can use some other algorithm to generate this rule base. Not only the rule base, but also the database. So that's is the main part of my research in the master as well as the PhD degree. That is, I applied some algorithm for generating this database as well as this rule base automatically. Only thing I need to give the variable, and I need to provide the number of linguistic variable that I want to divide. So then the algorithm will automatically do all these tasks. So this I will explain you in the next day session, because it deals with some kind of algorithm that can be easily attached with the Fuzzy Expert system for automatic generation of database and rule base. As of now, participant, please understand that to design an expert system for any problem, once the input variable and output variable is given, then it is the duty to generate database and rule base. Once this database and rule base is generated, then it is fed into the expert system. Then the expert system will automatically do the task of inference engine by the standard model and defuzzification to produce the output. Here one question has been asked by you. What is meant by fuzzification? Where the fuzzification is there? See, fuzzification as well as the generation of knowledge is linked with one another. So quality of service is divided into partitioning with the poor, good and excellent as linguistic variable. That task is called fuzzification. So once each individual variable is fuzzified, that means once each individual variable at the task of fuzzification is done, then it is associated with membership function. So that is said to be completed the task of generating the database. I hope you understand the generation of database involves fuzzification task followed by attaching the membership function. So if fuzzification task plus attaching the membership function, then it is the task of generating the database. Rule base is something different. You have to go and get the experience, and that experience can be written as a conditional statement. Or what you can do is you can use data mining based algorithm or any optimization algorithm to generate such kind of rule base. So that is the idea here, to generate the rule knowledge base for this problem. Next, I will explain the execution scenario, because the other two components, inference engine and a defuzzifier model, are nothing but some standard models available, and it is working based on the principles of that standard model. So now I will explain how the database as well as the rule base is utilized to get the total amount of tips according to the input given by the user or the customer. So this is the picture that gives you the understanding of execution of rule base and database inside the fuzzy inference engine to get into the defuzzifier block, from which output is produced. For which, let me understand this diagram in the horizontal wise. Look at the point 1, 2, 3. One, there is a gray color portion here, right? There is the rule. If service is poor or food is rancid, then tip is cheap. Come to second one, the gray color box. If service is good, then tip is average. Look at the third point. If service is excellent or food is delicious, then tip is generous. So these three are the rules. What are the, what is the diagram above the rule? So participants, I think you understand, this is nothing but the membership function associated with service. This is the membership function associated with food. And this is the membership function associated with service that is treated as good. It is the, there is no membership function for the second linguistic, because no second linguistic is available here. Likewise, this is the membership function associated with excellent. This is the membership function associated with delicious. See, remember participant, for service is poor, good, excellent. There are three linguistic variables. For each linguistic variable, membership function is assigned. For poor, half bell MF function is used. For good, full bell function is used. And for excellent, half bell MF function is used. Likewise, for the food variable, rancid, half trapezoidal function is used. Likewise, for food delicious, half trapezoidal function is used. Coming to this point, this output variable for tip. For the variable tip, you have divided the variable into cheap, average and generous. For each linguistic cheap, average, generated, triangular membership function each is assigned to each linguistic variable. Participants, I think you understand now. So what is the task of fuzzification? Dividing the input variable into linguistic variable. So how the service input variable is divided? Service input variable is divided into poor, good and excellent as the linguistic variable. After dividing the linguistic variable into input variable into linguistic variable, the task of pacification is set to over. But to generate the database, each linguistic variable is associated with membership function. So poor is associated with half bell mf, good is associated with full mf, excellent is associated with half bell mf function. Likewise, other linguistic variable has to be understood. I hope you understand the first portion of this diagram. Let me explain the way in which the inference engine is worked out. To make the inference engine execute, when the inference engine get executed after receiving the input from the customer. Say for example, in the kiosk, the customer fed 3 for service and 8 for food. So in that scenario, so now what we have to do is these three rules have to be simultaneously verified for the value service equal to 3. Likewise, for the word food equal to 8, these rules have been simultaneously studied. So when the service equal to 3, see, there is a line here. From the service, there is a line here. Here it is dotted line, and the line goes up to the first rule. See, there is a vertical line here. So it is in the excellent membership, it is cutting here. In the good membership function, it is cutting here. In the poor membership function, it is cutting here. Likewise, for the variable food equal to delicious, if you get food equal to 8, it is cut in the delicious here. In the second rule, there is no linguistic variable. In the first rule, it is cut here. So likewise, the input variable, first it is mapped to the corresponding linguistic variable to get the degrees of value. So this is said to be the first step, that is fuzzify inputs. Next to the second operation, apply fuzzy operation. Second step, that is second step, third step, and fourth step, apply aggregation method. Apply fuzzy operation, apply implication method, apply aggregation. These are the four major steps of any inference engine. So apply fuzzy operation. So the rule is applied here. Let me take the first rule. For the poor, the point cut here is somewhere above 0. But for the rancid, food equal to 8, the rule cut is 0 only. So which is maximum? The poor value is maximum. So in the output, it is cut when the area which is equivalent to the poor, and those output is taken out here. See, what is this? This is nothing but the triangular membership curve, which is treated for cheap, has been cut for the rule 1 with respect to poor, and this area is displayed here. Likewise, coming to the second rule. So if second rule, service equal to 3 is cut here. So this value is something near to 1 in the y-axis. Here there is no place. So automatically the entire portion of the portion in which it is covered for the good linguistic is taken. Look at the arrow in the horizontal direction. So those portion have been taken out, and it is displayed here. It is displayed here. Likewise, here, service equal to 3. In excellent, it is cut in the 0, whereas food equal to 8 is cut in the delicious, somewhere near to 1. So those portion is taken. Now, you think about these three portions. Think about your three portions, this portion, and this portion, and this portion. By applying the minimum operation, these three portions have been taken out. So which is minimum? Those value has been taken out. So those are these values. Then over this operation, then what is the method you applied? You have applied some kind of aggregation method, and it is aggregated. See, all the three values are aggregated. That's why this first component corresponds to first portion. This second one corresponds to second portion. The third peak corresponds to third portion. This is the aggregated value of simultaneous execution of all the three rules for the two input variable values. This way, your entire inference engine is working out. Apply fuzzy operation, apply implication method, and apply aggregation method. After this aggregation, what is the method is used? Defuzzification method is used. For which, what is the method here? Centroid method. So once the centroid method is applied, that is centroid of this area is calculated, and it is returned as the final output. So what is the final output is returned? The final output return is TP equal to 16.7%. That is for the when the customer gives the rating for services 3, food is equal to 80, then the customer billed amount is 100, then how much amount he paid to the wait person? 16 rupees 70 paise is the amount paid by the wait person to the paid by the customer to the wait person. So in such way, the execution scenario for export system for any problem can be understood. And this execution scenario is the one given for the tipping problem. Participants, I hope you understand the idea here. Next, building this kind of export system with fuzzy logic toolbox. In MATLAB, you will be provided with a lot of facilities to execute the concept of fuzzy with respect to designing an export system, for which you have to go to fuzzy logic toolbox. In older version only, it is said as toolbox. Now it is fuzzy designer app. So you have to go to the fuzzy designer app. When you go to fuzzy designer app, the first window that you will be provided is fuzz editor. In this fuzz editor, you will need to give the input variable, linguistics available, and other kind of parameters you have to give. Then followed by fuzz editor, the other editor available is membership function editor. Here only you have to give the membership function for each category for the input variable food. You have two linguistic variable, good and delicious. Likewise for the input variable service, it is poor. Like that, you have to give membership function editor in the membership function editor window of the Fuzzy Logic toolbox. Then after that, that is a rule editor window. Here you have to edit the rule. If service is poor or the food is rancid, what is the cheap amount? Like that rule you have to write here. After having done these three screen is set to over, then this screen, that is rule viewer, is the output screen. Here there is one box is here. This box is used to give the input. Once you give the input, you got the output here. So this is the way you can interact with the MATLAB software for fuzzy logic based export system development. So let me explain this idea with the help of the toolbox, for which I switch over my presentation to MATLAB screen. Let me stop this screen first. Then I will go to the MATLAB screen. Where is MATLAB here? So in that MATLAB screen, you can find a three tabbed pan, home, plots, app. Here you go to app pan. So in the app pan, you can find an app called Fuzzy Logic Designer. You just click that app. If you click that app, this a screen will appear. That is the screen for editing the fuzzy export system the variable details, that is both input and output variables. I think this screen is not visible because I have to share this screen also. I think so. Participant, the editor screen is visible? I don't think so, it is visible. What I can do is I can stop the share and I go to that share. Yeah, yes, this one. Oh, yes. So I think now it is visible, right? Yes. So this screen, you have to decide the number of input variable as well as output variable. For our case, what is the input variable? Quality of service and food. So I have to go and do the task. Where is it? Yes, here. So what I have to do is, let me open the MATLAB also on that screen. So I just click over the red color box, or you can go for file, new fuzz, edit, add variable input. In that case, now two input variable have been created. So first give the first input variable name. What is the name of the first variable? Service. So is there any other thing you want to do? Yeah, yes, it is a range. I think range can be done after that. So that is 0 to 10. Service is one variable. What is another variable? Another variable is food. Food I have made. So close. Now two variables are being made. Oh, screen sharing is closed. Right. Okay. So app. Fuzzy designer toolbox. So here. Share the screen. Fuzzy toolbox. Yes. So adding the two variable. Edit variable. Add variable input. So I think this screen is visible. Maybe I will check once again. Is this screen visible? Yes. So input, I will be giving the variable food service first. Service and here food, then output tips. So I mentioned all the three variable name, service, input. And now after that I need to give edit the linguistic variable, for which I have to double click on this screen, or you can go for add membership function, edit membership function. If I do that, then it will go to this screen. I think this screen is also not visible. Let me stop the screen and then I will go one second. Stop the screen. Share the screen of this window. Yes, this window. So this window is available. So in this window, you have to define the membership function. So let me take this membership function as what membership function? See, M of 1. Let me take this, name this M of 1 as food. Since the, what is the variable here? This is service. Service is how many linguistic variable it is divided? I think poor, good, excellent. So I am going to divide this, name this as poor. Poor. For this variable, good. And for this variable, excellent. So I divide the variable into three variable accordingly. If you want to change the type of membership function, I can change. For by default, it is a try MF is there. So I may change the variable. Say for example, these many membership functions are available. Try MF, trapezoidal MF. Try MF is triangular membership function. Trap MF is trapezoidal. Bell, Gaussian bell MF, Gaussian, like that, so many membership. So I will use trapezoidal membership function. So then I will take a little bit. See, I can adjust. See, look at this block color dot. I can adjust like this. First of all, I have to change the range. What is the range? 0 to 10, right? 0 to 10. So I change the range 0 to 10. So poor I've designed. Good, I have to decide. So good, I can retain with TryMF. But I will have to change the value here. 1, something 2.5, I will left here. Likewise, I left here up to 7.5. And then for excellent, select that variable excellent. And I can choose, go for trapezoidal. So just to value this. See, you can expand this or you can change the value here. This is also possible. Instead of 6.5, I can say that 6.6. Like that I can do. See, it is accordingly changing, right? So in, for poor, since it is like this, see, I want to change this first value, second value, third value. This is the third value. Totally four values are there. This value I want to change means then I can give here as 1.5. So see, it is adjusted. So likewise, you have to decide the variable for what is that? Service variable for food. Food, how many variables? There are two variables, two linguistic variable only. So one variable I have deleted. for food, that is what is that? How many linguistic variables use? Two. One is a rancid. Another one is delicious. So for that, rancid food is rancid. First MF is rancid. Rancid. And then I will use G bell MF function. So rancid. I will expand the value like this. G MF function rancid. And for here, another one is food is rancid. Then one more is delicious. So for delicious case, I will change the membership function as delicious. Delicious. After changing this as delicious, then I have to change the membership. Say, for example, I am using Gauss. So then I will tune the value. Likewise, I will bring that value here. So this is, I need to have some overlap so that the concept of fuzzy. So this is the scenario for food. If I design the expert system, that might be like something like this. Then going to tips, totally how many linguistic variable? I think for three linguistic variable, cheap, average, generous. So cheap, first one cheap. So I will go for trapezoidal. Half trapezoidal, I will adjust the values. See, for your understanding only, as well as for the timeout. So I am just doing it with the help of the cursor. But to be strictly speaking, you have to carefully give the parameter value here. Then only you will get the output exactly. Otherwise, it will like a fun method only. You will get whatever the output that is interpreted based on the value given here. So then the second one cheap. After that, the variable is cheap, average and generous, right? Cheap. Then average, for which, okay, average, average. The membership function that might be trapezoidal, I can go for. So I can expand like this. And like this, yes, average. Then finally, generous. Another membership function is generous. Generous. So this I will go for trapezoidal. So I can use like this. So this portion is the overlapping portion. Here only we need to take care of the fuzzy. Not we, the fuzzy has to take care of the value, how to design the final value. So the range may be, I think, 5% to 25%. That means 0.5 to 25%, maybe 2.5, 0.05, 5%, 0.100, 0.05 to 0.25. 0.25. So that is the total of the total bit. So that is the range. See, 0.05 to 0.25, the range has been changed, right? So now what is the task is set to complete? The generation of database task is set to complete. Then what you have to do is you have to go for editing the rule, that is considering the rule base, for which edit, I think rule. So one more screen is open. That is the third screen, rule editor. I hope this screen is not visible to you. Let me stop the screen. Then I will share that screen. Stop. Share the screen. Where is the rule editor? Yeah, you here. So rule editor. So I hope now the screen is visible to you. That is rule editor screen. Now we have to write the rule. So what are the three rules given for this problem? If service is poor or food is rancid, then tip is cheap. So that is rule editor. If service is poor, or, so you have to put R, right? So you have to make a connection R. If service is poor, so poor is selected. So that means service is poor. Or food is rancid, so it is selected. Or food is rancid. Rancid, then tip is cheap. So first rule is created. So after making sure that the values are selected correctly, then there is a button called add rule. So you have to click the button add rule. So that rule is added like this. See, if service is poor or food is rancid, that tip is cheap. And what is the next rule? The next rule is if service is good, then tip is average. So that rule, if service is good, if service is good, no need to worry about this. Then tip is average. So I need to omit that. So I got put not average. So that is the case. So then add rule. So that rule is added here. So I have to omit this condition. So for which I need to delete that rule, change the rule. So I need to edit it here. So okay, maybe none you can put, yes. And then maybe I delete this rule. If service is good or food is none, then tip is average. So order. So if service is good, then tip is average, right? So with the help of none, I can do it. So what is then the third rule? What is the third rule? Third rule, if service is excellent or food is delicious, then tip is service is excellent or food is delicious. Service is excellent. Service is excellent or the food is delicious. Then the tip is generous. So add rule. So three rules are added. So what we have done so far, you have entered into the fuzzy logic toolbox. There you have decided the number of input variable and the output variable, and you have given the name for input variable and output variable. Followed by that, for each input variable and output variable, you have divided the variable into linguistics. And for each linguistic, you have assigned the membership function and defined the range for each membership function. And finally, you have edited the editor window, that is rule editor window, with the rule. Once the thing is set done, finally, what you have to do is you have to execute the system. So to execute the system, where you have to go is, let me stop this screen and we'll go to the screen in which you have to execute the rule. So this screen you have to go. So this is the screen you have to go and execute the system. So here there is a menu called view. So view, there is a menu rule. So you have to click that rule. So one more screen is open. I think it is not visible to you. Let me stop the share screen and then go to that screen. Where is that screen? The rule view screen. Yeah, yes, here. So this is the screen in which you can get output. See, by default, if service is 5 and food is also 0.5, it is given, then the tip is 0.153. So I want to change the value. So if service is in this range 1 to, sorry, we forgot one thing. Food is given is 0 to 1. We forgot to make the change. Let me make that change and then come. What change we forgot to make is, if you go to food, the food range we have not modified. So let me modify that. Food range, it is modified to 0 to 10. Yes, now it is modified. Where I can modify this? Here. Let me show that screen. Share screen for this screen. See, here I forgot to modify that screen. Is it visible? I think it is visible. Share the screen. Stop sharing. Share the screen. Here. So here the food, originally they see the range. Here it is given as 0 to 1. Now it is modified to 0 to 10. So this is done. So now where you have to go is view rules. Let me go to that screen, sharing the screen. So I stop this screen and go to that rule screen. So this is the final output screen, rule viewer window. That window is rule editor window. And this window is a rule viewer window. Here you have to give the value. See now the value. Service is 0 to 10 scale. Food is also 0 to 10 scale. And tip amount is 0.05. That means 5% to 0.25. That is 25%. So if I give the rating as, what is the rating? Service is 3 and food is 8. If I give, then I can see the output here. See, tip amount is 0.11. That means 11 rupees 10 paise is the tip amount that I can give. So in that example screen that is explained, something has been calculated and it is given a 16.7. For exact simulation, the value that we got is 11.10 rupees. So what might be the change is the boundary values, that is the parameter value, we cannot give it correctly. If you give it correctly, you can get the correct value. But this is the idea that you have to do it for designing any expert system using the fuzzy logic toolbox. Now, if some customer coming and putting 10 for food, food is services also great, and food is also great. That is a 10-10. Then what is the tip amount? See, the tip amount is 22.10 rupees. That is maximum tip amount. So likewise, if I give 0 to 10 rice, for here also 0 and here also 0. That is service also 0 and food is also 0. Then what is the value? 0.07. That is only 70 paise. So that is no tips amount is given. So likewise, the hotel manager will decide the amount of tips received by the wait person of the particular table. Accordingly, he will fix the salary if he is interested in such kind of salary payment to the employee. So this is the way an expert system is designed for a tipping problem. So let me give one more case study so that you can understand that case study, and you can do it on your own if your time permits, or if you are really interested in this particular topic of research. So I will stop the presentation. I will go to the presentation. Yes. So the next case study that I'm going to discuss with you is design of fuzzy washing machine. You know washing machine, it's automatic washing machine, sixth sense enabled washing machine, refrigerator. So many electronics items are there which comes with Intelli as a prefix word. That means some kind of fuzzy is enabled in the system. So here the simple case study is taken how to design the fuzzy washing machine with respect to the concept of fuzzy logic. So you have to decide the input parameter and output parameter. So the input given here is actual weight, fabric types, amount of the three input weight, amount of output is amount of detergent, washing time, agitation, water level, temperature. This is the output for a simple washing machine to be automated. To illustrate how to generate a fuzzy expert system for this particular case study, let me take two input variable because it is easy to understand and easy to make you to do it on your own. So what are the two input variable? Dirtiness and weight. Two input variables. So this dirtiness of the cloth, first parameter. Second parameter is weight. That is weight of the cloth. That is, you are going to put a shirt inside the washing machine. So what are the two input value you are giving to the washing machine? How much amount of dirt is present in the washing machine? And what is the weight of the shirt in the washing machine? And what your washing machine will have to decide, will have to decide automatically amount of detergents. So imagine a washing machine which has come with automatic loading of detergent, where a small tank is attached with a slot where your detergent is poured. So it may be a powder form or it may be a liquid form. Some tank is attached. After you putting the load into the machine, once you switch on the button, the washing machine will measure the dirtiness of the shirt, weight of the shirt by means of some sensor. According to the value that it measured, it will suck the detergent powder or detergent liquid to the required level it needs to make the dress washable. So that is the case study. You can also think about it. You can also do such kind of research further. But anyhow, before that, you can do some simulation with the help of the fuzzy logic toolbox that is explained for the tipping problem. So what is the first step you have to do? You have to do the task of fuzzification. What is fuzzification? Given the variable, you have to find out the linguistic variable. So how many variables given? Two input variable and one output variable. For each input variable as well as for the output variable, you have to decide the linguistic variable. That is, you have to partition the variable and you have to decide the linguistic variable. That's it. The fuzzification task is over. Then what is the database creation? The same fuzzification task plus for each linguistic variable, you have to associate a membership function. That is the creation of database. What is the rule base? Creation of conditional statement. So let me explain this. See, input one, dirtiness. Let me take the range as 0 to 100 for understanding purpose. The subsets are, that is the linguistic variables are, for dirtiness, almost clean, dirty, soiled, filthy. As for weight, the range is 0 to 100. The subsets are very light, light, heavy, very heavy. Likewise, for output, the values are range 0 to 100. Subsets are very light, little, much, very much, maximum. So for each linguistic variable, you have to decide the range, and then you have to decide the membership function, trapezoidal, triangular, triangular, trapezoidal, like that. So you have to decide. After deciding all these things, what is set to done? The creation of database is set to done. Then the rule base. So rule base can be given as a if then conditional statement form, or you can give it this is a form of a matrix. See, weight is read in the row wise, dirtiness is read in the column wise, and corresponding value is read inside the table values. So how to read this table in the form of if then statement? See, if weight is very light, if dirtiness is almost clean, then apply detergent very little. See where it two coincides, very light and almost clean coincides, the value is very little. Likewise, if weight is heavy and dirtiness is soiled, then apply detergent very much. If weight is very light, sorry, weight is light and dirtiness is filthy, then apply detergent much. So this way you have to decide the conditional statement for all the cases. Totally how many rules? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So totally, I think 16 rules are possible. 16 rules are possible. So after knowing all these things, what is the thing you have to do? You have to feed this information into the fuzzy logic toolbox. Like I explained with the help of tipping problem, then you will get the corresponding response. So let me stop the screen and go to the MATLAB screen. Stop. MATLAB screen. Share the screen. MATLAB, where it is located? Oh, gets closed. Yes, it gets closed. Yes, here. I think now it is possible. Share. Yes, it's coming. So MATLAB screen. So MATLAB screen. Here, what I have to do is I have to go to app and go to Fuzzy Designer app. So the window is open. For time shake, to restrict the time, I have already created this export system. So then I am going to import this export system into this environment. File. I think this screen is also not visible. So many screens are there today's class. So every time I have to stop and share, stop, share. So this screen. So here in this screen, I am going to open the Fuzzy Export system for the model, because for a time constraint, I have already created. You have to do import, import file, import from file. So it takes to the location where I have USRFTP 28.5 of yes, washing machine dot this. It is the extension is .fis. So if you open, yeah, yes, the screen is open. I think this screen is not visible to you. Let me close the present screen, stop the present screen and share that screen. So this one. So this screen, see dirtiness, weight and detergent. So this is the scenario. What is the model that is used? Mamdani model. So what is the range? It is 0 to 100. So next, what step you have to do? You have to go, or you have to double click that variable. After double clicking the variable, some screen is applied. Some screen is coming. That this screen is called membership function editor screen. So it is not visible to you right now. Let me stop the screen and go to that screen. Stop this screen. Where is the screen? Yes, this screen. So this is membership function. Dirtiness, almost clean, dirty, soiled, filthy. What is the range? 0 to 100 is the range. For almost clean, trapezoidal MF, the parameters and its parameters, 30 and its parameters likewise, weight. So the membership functions are like this, for very light, light, heavy and very heavy. So the membership functions are Gauss MF, G Bell MF, Gaussian MF. So those parameters are here. So the values are likewise the detergent, triangular, trapezoidal, sorry, G Bell MF, trapezoidal for very much, Gauss MF for maximum, Gauss MF. So very little, triangular, light, little, much, very much, maximum. So all these has to be done in the membership function editor window. What is the third window? It is the rule editor window in which you have to edit the rule. So I will go to the rule editor window, edit rules. How to go to the rule editor window? Edit rules. So edit rules, if I give, the window is open. That window is not visible to you. Let me stop this window and go to that window. So this is the window. See, you did, this is the, I have encoded all the rules, 16 rules. See, 16 rules, 1 to 16, see here, 16 rules. So all the rules I have edited, like the way I explained for the tipping problem, all the rules have been edited. After the rule editing process, then what is the step? So you have to view the output. For viewing the output, you go view, then you have to select the rules. I am going to click that one, view rules. At the first time, you won't see the screen. So I will stop the screen and go to that screen again. View rules. So stop that screen. So share screen, rule viewer, share. See this screen. This is the rule screen, viewer screen. Dirtiness 50-50 is there initially. The shirt, dirtiness of the shirt is 50. Then weight of the shirt is 50. Then the amount of detergent is 64.1. So I can change the value here. Let me take dirtiness is 0 as well as the weight of the shirt is also 0. Then what is the value? See, detergent is some small amount, 18. Likewise, if the dirtiness is 100 and this one is 100 and almost the weight will be 84 amount of detergent has to be paid, has to be poured. Likewise, I can change any values here, 90 here, and for dirtiness, it is a 10. If I put that, so it is giving the value as, see, 60.8. So that is the idea of executing the Fuzzy Expert System model. I hope, participant, you understand the way of designing the Fuzzy Expert System model through MATLAB software. Anyhow, if you want to do on your own, I have some other case study also. Let me stop the screen. I will share the screen of our presentation. Yes, here. So what is, so I think, I hope the presentation screen is visible now, right? So the presentation screen. So what is the next case study I wish to show to you? See, these are the screen be visible. Every time I have make the screen, stop the screen and view the screen, see completely all the screen. So the first screen is the input editor screen, input and output editor screen. Input is edited and output is also edited by giving the name. The second screen is the membership function editor screen. Here you have to edit the membership function for both the input and output. And the third screen is here. Yes, this is also membership function editor screen. Third screen is here. So this screen. So this screen is the rule editor screen, to which you can edit the rules. And this is the output screen, using which you can see the, you can feed the input to here in this box and get the output. This one is the surface where there is 2D viewer of seeing the output produced by the network. See along the weight in x-axis and dirtiness in dirtiness in x-axis and weight in y-axis, what is the amount of detergent we have to pay for all the scenarios. The graph has been plotted and you can view that graph for understanding and for clarity if you need. So the next case study may be designing a turbine controller for using Fuzzy Logic. I don't go much into the slide. Just to note it down, input variable pressure, another input variable is a temperature. Its linguistic variables are given, the range is given. What is the range? 0 to 250 is for pressure and 0 to 350 is for temperature. How many linguistic is divided? Weak, low, okay, strong, high. Pressure, temperature, cold, cool, normal, warm, hot, it is temperature. And what is the output throttle action? Its range is minus 60 to 60. What is NL? Negative low, negative medium, negative small, zero, positive small, positive medium, positive L. That is a throttle action. You have all. Imagine a controller based on the input to the controller, that is the pressure and the temperature, you have to either increase the valve of the controller or reduce the valve of the control or simply close the valve. So that is the scenario. So for which the fuzzy if-then conditional statements are given in the tabular form, it is called as fuzzy associative memory. So this is the way in which you can understand the case study and you can go for designing the fuzzy based turbine controller. And another case study is fuzzy image processing. So the case study given here is some kind of satellite images, and your objective is to decide what portion the image is about, whether the portion of the image is saying any grass area or water area or forest area or some kind of pasture area or urban area. That is what our interest, to decide what type of area the image is showing. So for which the different color coding scheme have been used to understand the process. Yellow means a pasture, green forest, like that. Some, and for what you have to do is you have to analyze the portion, whether is yellow is concentrated more or green is concentrated more, based on the RGB value. So this is the input for the system. That is, RGB value is the input for the system. See, RGB. So these three are the input for the system. Mamdani system is used. Well, you have to give the output. That output may be of pasture area or forest area or urban area. So this is the way the linguistic have been designed. The rule editor. So you can use this scenario for developing one more expert system for such kind of image processing task. And finally, the another problem is the flower classification that I have told in the morning presentation with respect to jasmine, rotena, and fichi. The same thing we have discussed in the ANN class as flower classification with respect to an iris data. So same data. For that data, that is, you can download the data from UCI Machine Learning Repository. For that data, the database is created and a membership function is created. This is a result of my master research. So you can use this database as well as this rule base, and you can try fuzzy expert system on your own with the fuzzy logic toolbox. So I think, I hope I have given enough idea about how to design an fuzzy expert system. What are the components in the fuzzy expert system? Among the components, what are the components that plays a major role to design an expert system? And then with a few case study, I explained how to implement that case study with the MATLAB. And then I have given three more case study for you to take away, take to your home, or take with you for any kind of hands-on exercises. So if you face any difficulty while designing these expert system, that day itself I have given my email ID and I have given my mobile number. So you can contact me if you face any difficulty in developing expert system for such kind of things. Remember, this is fuzzy logic toolbox. Even though for a fresher seems to be little confusing or tough one, this is a toy problem. So this is very easier. Anyone can do it. But the most important problem that you have to focus is generating the database as well as generating the rule base on your own by using some algorithms. That is the more important part of the research before designing the fuzzy expert system for any kind of task, either numerical data classification or image classification or any controller based task. So with this, I close the today afternoon session, and these are the references you can refer for understanding further into the theory and many ideas related to fuzzy logic. So if you have any question, you can ask the question. I am open to you. Okay, participant, if you want to ask any question, you can raise your hands. Participants, if you have any question. So if you don't have a question to ask, so I think let me stop the presentation. Okay, organizer, can you please come and address the participants if you want to say anything to the participant? So thank you, participant. Thank you for your patient listening. I wish you to take this idea further into your topic of research. So thank you. I think the organizer will contact you through WhatsApp or email about the tomorrow session. So I will close the session. Thank you. Thank you one and all. See you tomorrow.